Hello students, now I am going to start the next topic of this chapter, life processes. This is human digestive system. In human digestive system, first of all, let me to explain that what is digestion. Digestion is the process of the conversion of complex food materials into the simpler form. As you know, whatsoever the food materials we intake, we ingest from outside, these food materials are very complex. And the complex food materials as such do not absorb by our body cells and tissues, as the body cells and tissues are very small, microscopic. So the food molecules must be in a very fine molecules, so it can be easily absorbed by the body cells and tissues. It can easily move through the blood vessels, through the blood, and can go to the body cells and tissues for the different functions. So digestion is the process of the conversion of complex food materials into the simpler form with the help of digestive enzymes. So many digestive enzymes are produced by our digestive systems. I will explain through this diagram about the role of the enzymes, that how enzymes, they are useful to digest our complex food into the simpler form. I have written here human digestive system. What is digestive system? To digest the food in the human being, the nature has given us a well-developed digestive system, and the digestive system is made up of two parts, that is human alimentary canal and digestive glands. Alimentary canal and digestive glands, both are collectively called digestive system. What is alimentary canal? Alimentary canal is a long tubular structure which is extended from mouth and ends into the anus. So this is the human alimentary canal, and you can see here in this diagram the human alimentary canal is associated with these two glands, liver and pancreas. So alimentary canal and digestive glands, these two digestive glands are collectively called human digestive system. The human digestive system consist of the following parts: mouth, then mouth is followed by this buccal cavity. As you know, mouth is the aperture, is the slit which lies in between the two movable lips, upper and lower lip. The mouth opens inside the buccal cavity. The buccal cavity is then followed by esophagus. It is a long tubular structure. It forms here a sac-like structure, a bag-like structure. This is stomach. Then stomach, it forms the small intestine. Actually, small intestine has three parts. Not so many levelings are given in class 10th NCERT, But you should know the small intestine is made up of three parts, that is duodenum, then jejunum, and the last part is ileum. So this one is the duodenum. That duodenum, it becomes highly coiled, and this coiled tubular structure is called jejunum. Here I can write jejunum, and the last part of the small intestine is the ileum part, and now the ileum opens into the large intestine. The small intestine is nearly 6 meter in length. It is the longest part of the human alimentary canal. It is nearly 6 meter in length and 2.5 centimeter in the diameter. But why it is said to be the small intestine? A small intestine because of the narrow diameter. The diameter is here 2.5, this diameter, and here diameter is nearly 6.5 centimeter. So on the basis of the diameter, the small intestine and large intestine, these names have been given. Large intestine, not on the basis of the length, on the basis of the diameter. The diameter is 6.5 centimeter, and here the diameter is only 2.5 centimeter. As per length is concerned, the small intestine is the largest part of the human alimentary canal, nearly 6 meter in length. Now the large intestine, you can see here, the large intestine is also divided into so many parts. This one is the cecum. Here I can write cecum, then colon, and the last one is the rectum. So these three parts are there of the large intestine. Cecum, this wide structure, this is cecum. The terminal portion of the cecum is called appendix. It is the vestigial organ of the human being. The appendix is well developed in herbivores, means the animals eat grasses, and the from here up to here, this one is the colon, the largest part of the large intestine, and this colon is followed by, you can label here, colon, the rectum, and rectum is followed by anus, through which the food gets discharged outside. Now I will explain the functions of each part, that how the food molecules are digested inside the human alimentary canal, or you can say in the digestive system. Human, like the amoeba and other animals, is also a also performs holozoic mode of nutrition. And I have already discussed in the previous lesson that in holozoic mode of nutrition, so many steps are there: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and egestion. So all these steps occur in human digestive system also. Means the human also performs holozoic mode of nutrition. Let us see here the functions of the human alimentary canal, that how the food molecules are digested inside the alimentary canal by the actions of different enzymes. The mouth helps to intake the food from outside. Then where food goes? The food goes inside our buccal cavity. The buccal cavity. And you can see inside the buccal cavity, the teeth are there. The teeth help to crush the food. The teeth helps in the mechanical crushing of the food, and the food comes into the fragmented form. Inside the buccal cavity on the palate, there is a gland, and the name of this gland is called salivary gland. You see here, salivary gland. Where salivary gland is present? Inside on the roof of the buccal cavity, salivary gland is present. Salivary gland produces saliva. When you eat the food, you can see the saliva is secreted inside our buccal cavity, and the saliva comes from the salivary gland. Saliva contains a special enzyme for the digestion of starch, and this special enzyme is known as salivary amylase. Salivary amylase, and this enzyme is also known as tylein enzyme. Salivary amylase. Now you see the function of the salivary amylase. The salivary amylase converts starch. And you know, starch is the complex food. It is the complex form of the food which you intake from outside through different food sources. When you eat potato, rice, wheat, all these food sources contain starch, which is the complex food. And this complex food starch is converted into the sugar by the action of which enzyme? Salivary amylase enzyme. There is special sugar, and the name of this sugar is called maltose. So salivary amylase enzyme, or you can say tylein enzyme, helps to convert the complex food, that is starch, into the simple sugar, that is maltose. The maltose further breaks down inside the small intestine to give rise to the glucose. One thing is very, very important. You should know the simpler form of the food. Generally, we intake the food from outside, that is starch, a type of carbohydrate. It is a complex food. The simplest form of the starch, when the starch is completely digested, it gives rise to the glucose. Glucose is the simplest form. Glucose do not undergo into the process of digestion because it is already the simpler form. So starch always digested into the glucose. Glucose is the simplest form of the starch. If you are taking proteins from outside, what is the simpler form of the protein? Proteins converted into the amino acids. So many amino acids are consist together, and it forms the complex form, that is called protein. And one more food you can see here, fat. And fat is digested into the fatty acids and glycerol. So before I start all these things, once again you can see here, the simplest form of the starch is what? Glucose. not only glucose, glucose, fructose and galactose, the simpler form of the starch. Proteins are finally digested into the amino acids, and fat molecules are digested into the fatty acids and glycerol. So, I am explaining here the function of the salivary amylase. What is the salivary amylase? Salivary amylase converts starch into the sugar, and this sugar is the partially digested sugar, maltose, because it further breaks down into the glucose inside the small intestine. Now, this structure is called esophagus. What is the function of esophagus? The esophagus helps to push the food from the buccal cavity towards the stomach. Esophagus is also known as food pipe. It propels, it pushes the food towards the stomach. It's very, very important that you have to learn that esophagus do not digest any type of food materials, because esophagus do not have any enzymes for the digestion of food molecules. Esophagus, or you can say the food pipe, only propels the food, pushes the food from upward to the downward into the stomach. How the food from the buccal cavity, it comes inside the esophagus. The esophagus walls, here this is the wall of the esophagus. The wall of the esophagus has a special type of movement that is called peristalsis. Peristalsis, or you can say peristaltic movement. Peristaltic movement means the muscular contraction, the muscles, the wall of the esophagus contract and relax, contract and relax. So food comes forward inside the stomach. Now, what is stomach and how the food is digested inside the stomach? Stomach is a bag-like structure. It is a sac. When the food comes inside the stomach, the wall of the stomach contains a special type of gland. This is called gastric gland. What is the name of this gland present in the wall of the stomach? Gastric gland. And gastric gland producing gastric juice. And gastric juice contains the enzymes that is pepsin. Gastric lipase, HCl and mucus also. Now let me to explain the functions of all these secretions, that is pepsin, gastric lipase, hydrochloric acid, mucus, etc. Pepsin is a protein digestive enzyme. It digests the proteins. You can see here, the proteins are digested into the peptones or peptides. What is the difference between the proteins and peptones? Actually, the proteins, each protein molecule had so many amino acids. Now, it is broken down into the small fragments, and these small fragments are called peptones. Means proteins here not completely digested. As I told you, the proteins are finally digested into the amino acids. But amino acids are not produced here. Inside the stomach, the proteins are partially digested. It's a very big chain, and so many small chains are formed by the action of which enzyme? Pepsin. You have to learn that pepsin is a protein digestive enzyme present inside the gastric juice. The gastric lipase enzyme is a fat digestive enzyme. It converts fat into the fatty acids and glycerol. Now you see here the function of the hydrochloric acid, HCl. It's very, very important. Sometimes there will be the question that what are the functions of hydrochloric acid? The hydrochloric acid has so many functions. The first, hydrochloric acid maintains acidity inside the stomach for the proper action of pepsin enzyme. The pepsin enzyme, please learn it. The pepsin enzyme inside the stomach works best in the acidic environment. If the medium is alkaline, pepsin do not digest proteins. Pepsin needs the acidic environment inside the stomach to digest the proteins, and that acidity is maintained by hydrochloric acid. So hydrochloric acid maintains acidic environment inside the stomach for the proper action of pepsin enzyme. Second, hydrochloric acid also kills the germs present inside the food. If we are getting the food from outside, may the food is contaminated, may have so many germs, bacteria, fungus. So if the germs are coming through the food, all the germs are killed inside the stomach by the hydrochloric acid, by HCl. Now, the third one is the mucus. The mucus, what is the role of the mucus? Mucus protects the inner lining of the alimentary canal, inner lining of the stomach especially, from the harmful effect of the hydrochloric acid. You can ask, sir, if the hydrochloric acid is produced inside the stomach, it can destroy the wall of the stomach. But the wall of the stomach is well coated by the mucus. So hydrochloric acid do not destroy the wall. Even the enzymes do not digest their own walls of the alimentary canal. So mucus protects the wall of alimentary canal, that is stomach and small intestine, from the harmful effect of hydrochloric acid and other enzymes. Now from the stomach, then where food goes? The food goes to the duodenum. The duodenum, it is the first part of the small intestine, as I told you. The duodenum receives two secretions from the liver and from the pancreas. Here you can see these two glands are there. Liver produces bile juice, and bile juice from the liver, it comes inside the gallbladder through the bile duct. And again, the bile juice from the gallbladder, it comes inside the duodenum. It helps in the process of digestion.
It's very, very important. Suppose there is a question that name the organ, name the gland which produces bile juice. You will write liver. Name the organ which stores bile juice, gallbladder. And the bile juice, then it comes through the bile duct. This is bile duct to the duodenum. I will tell you the function later on. The pancreas produces pancreatic juice. And the pancreatic juice also comes inside the duodenum, which helps in the process of digestion. Now, functions of bile juice. Bile juice converts acidic food into alkaline food. And second, it helps in the process of emulsification. It helps in the process of emulsification. These two headings you try to understand. Bile juice helps in the conversion of acidic food into the alkaline food. As I taught you, inside the stomach, the nature of food is acidic because of the secretion of hydrochloric acid by the gastric gland. When the food comes from the stomach to the duodenum, the food must be in the alkaline. Otherwise, the enzymes present inside the pancreas, either in the small intestine, do not digest the food. As soon as the food comes from the stomach, inside the duodenum, the food becomes alkaline by the action of bile juice. So bile juice converts acidic food into the alkaline food for the proper action of trypsin enzyme present in the pancreas and other intestinal enzymes. Second, it helps in the process of emulsification. What is emulsification? Actually, emulsification is a physical process in which the big fat, the large fat, you can say, is converted into the small fat droplets, or you can say here emulsified fat. And later on, these emulsified fats are converted into the fatty acids and glycerol by the action of which enzyme? Lipase. Please say here. As I taught you, lipase is a fat digestive enzyme. It converts fat into the fatty acids and glycerol. But do you know, the lipase enzyme digests what kind of the fat? It digests emulsified fat, means the fat generally which we intake from outside through the butter or oils, ghee. These fats are not emulsified. Emulsified fats are the very small fats. You can see here the diagram, just like in the form of the droplets. If the fats are not emulsified, they are not small fat droplets, lipase do not digest fat into the fatty acids and glycerol. So, inside our alimentary canal, the bile juice, first of all, mechanically, not this is not the enzymatic process. The large fat is broken down into the small fat droplets, and this process of the conversion of big fat molecules into the small fat droplets are called emulsification. And later on, the emulsified fats are converted into the fatty acid cholesterol by the action of lipase enzyme. So these two functions are there. The bile juice helps to convert acidic food into alkaline food for the proper action of the trypsin enzyme, and bile juice also helps in the process of emulsification, and emulsification is the process of the conversion of large fat molecules into the small fat droplets, and this process of emulsification is required for the proper digestion of the fat into the fatty acids and glycerol by the action of lipase enzyme. Now, functions of pancreas. Pancreatic juice, and pancreatic juice contains the following components. These are trypsin, pancreatic lipase, pancreatic amylase. These are the components of the pancreatic juice. Trypsin, it is a protein digestive enzyme. The function of trypsin is same as the function of pepsin. But is there any difference? Yes. Pepsin is secreted by the stomach and trypsin is secreted by pancreas. Second, pepsin works in acidic medium while trypsin works in alkaline medium. But what is the similarity in pepsin and trypsin? Both are the protein digestive enzymes. Second, pancreatic lipase. Because the lipase is secreted from the pancreas, that's why it is named pancreatic lipase. If the lipase is secreted from the lipase, if the lipase is secreted from the small intestine, it is called intestinal lipase. But wherever the lipase enzyme is to be there, lipase enzyme is a fat digestive enzyme. It converts fat into the fatty acids and glycerol. And here, pancreatic amylase. The pancreatic amylase, the function is same, just like the salivary amylase. It is a starch digestive enzyme. It converts starch into the simple sugar, that is maltose. But this is not the salivary amylase. I have written it pancreatic amylase because the amylase is present where? In the pancreas. It is secreted by the pancreas. Suppose if the food is not, starch is not digested inside the buccal cavity, there is the chance of the digestion inside the duodenum by the action of amylase enzyme. Now, from the duodenum, then food where it goes? To the small intestine in the jejunum part. Ileum is the last part, and this highly coiled tubular structure, this is called jejunum. It's very, very important, I am telling you, that small intestine is the last destination where food is completely digested. After small intestine, there is no chance of the digestion of food. So small intestine, what are the functions of the small intestine? The small intestine is the last
portion is the last part of human alimentary canal where food is completely digested. What's about the food? Above, where partially digested, here all they are digested completely. The wall of the small intestine contains intestinal glands, and the intestinal glands produce a juice that is called intestinal juice. It contains the enzymes for the digestion of carbohydrates, proteins and fats. And overall, actually in class 10, it's not too much that what are the different enzymes and their function, but a brief introduction is to be there. That's why I am explaining that the small intestine produces the intestinal juice containing so many enzymes for the complete digestion of the food molecules. Now, the last part of the small intestine is the ileum. Ileum, the wall of the ileum, suppose this is the ileum wall. The wall of the ileum has so many finger-like projections. Hair-like projections, and these projections are called villi, and the villi increases the surface area of the ileum to absorb all the digested food. Ileum is the part of the small intestine which helps in the absorption of digested food. And villi helps in the absorption. It increases the surface area of the ileum, so this part can absorb more digested food. After the ileum, then you can see here the large intestine parts part comes. Large intestine, as I told you, has three parts mainly: cecum, colon and rectum. Overall, the large intestine is the part of the human alimentary canal where food is not digested. Large intestine helps to retain water. It helps to absorb water, and it contains some of the roughage, the food containing the cellulose. And large intestine also contains some of the useful bacteria like E. coli bacteria, Escherichia coli bacteria, which synthesize some of the vitamins which are useful for our body. And large intestine removes, the main function of the large intestine, it removes undigested food materials outside to the body through the anus. When the undigested food comes inside the large intestine, through the large intestine, all the undigested food materials comes inside the rectum, and when rectum is filled with the undigested food materials, the undigested food goes exterior outside through which part? Through the anus. So overall, large intestine helps in the conservation, in the retention of water, and large intestine removes undigested food materials outside to the body, and this process is known as egestion, or you can say defecation. So this was overall about the human digestive system, and it's very, very important to make the diagram. You please practice it at your home, make the diagram, level it, and you learn the functions of all these parts. I am giving you the assignment. Please note down some questions related to the topic which I taught today. Question number 1,
is note down in your copy
and you are supposed to complete it.
Name the enzyme, name an enzyme which helps in the digestion of starch inside the buccal cavity. Second, name the kind of movement, takes place in the esophagus to push food towards the stomach. To propel the food inside the stomach. Now, question number 3, note down. Write the functions of hydrochloric acid and mucus. Next question. What is emulsification? Write its importance. Next, name any two protein digestive enzymes. Next, write the functions of small and large intestine. And the last question is, make a leveled diagram of human digestive system. I hope you will complete the assignment which I have given to you. That's all. Tomorrow I will teach you the next topic. Thanks.